With the Lark by Paul Laurence Dunbar. Night is for sorrow and dawn is for joy, chasing the troubles that fret and annoy. Darkness for sign and daylight for song, cheery and chaste the strain, heartfelt and strong. All the night through, though I moan in the dark, I wake in the morning and sing with the lark. Deep in the midnight, the rain whips the leaves. Softly and sadly, the wood spirit grieves. But when the first hue of dawn tints the sky, I shall shake out my wings like the birds and be dry. And though like the raindrops I grieve through the dark, I shall wake in the morning and sing with the lark. On the high hills of heaven, some morning to be, where the rain shall not grace through the leaves of the tree. There my heart will be glad for the pain I have known, for my hand will be clasped in the hand of mine own. And though life has been hard and death's pathway been dark, I shall wake in the morning and sing with the lark. So that was the poem With the Lark by Paul Laurence Dunbar. I read it this morning on poets.org. They send out a daily email newsletter that has the poem of the day, and I highly recommend it. I'm going to include a link to the newsletter in the description for this video. They send some outstanding poetry, so highly recommend. Going back to the poem itself, I had never read it before, and I had never heard of Paul Laurence Dunbar, and I was very curious, so I looked him up, and according to poets.org, he was born in 1872, and despite being a good student growing up, he was never able to find employment that matched his intellect and range of skills, and that was due to extensive racial discrimination at the time. But when he was 19, his fortunes changed. He moved to Chicago to look for a job at the World Fair, which was being held in Chicago in 1891. And it was there that he met and became good friends with Frederick Douglass. And Douglass immediately saw the potential in this young man, connected him with other people, gave him an audience for his poetry readings, and eventually he became published, and he became really quite famous. According to poets.org, he was one of the first well-regarded, well-known, nationally famous African-American poets in the late 1800s. He ended up passing at the age of 33. In 1906, before his 34th birthday, which is really quite unfortunate, because when Douglass knew him, he himself said of Paul that this was perhaps the most talented and capable young African-American man living in the US at that time. We can still celebrate his poetry today. I was very happy to read this poem on poets.org. It's beautifully written. It conveys this sense of sadness and desperation, but also this strong underlying sense of hopefulness, which I think is great. So many people living throughout history, and of course in today's world, we can relate to these feelings as we go through our everyday lives. I hope to continue doing these poetry readings once a week, probably on Sundays. It could change depending on work, the different commitments that I have ongoing. Aside from that, I also hope to expand into doing video essays, longer analyses of different topics that are of interest to me. So keep an eye out for those. For those of you watching, I really appreciate it, and see you soon. Thanks.